Howdy, all, and welcome to Lex Lives. I think it's time we play a little Minecraft. That's so funny. Yes. All right. So I am gonna need some stone. Make some stone buttons out there. I've got plenty of dark oak on me. Ooh, I need to run out and get some iron, don't I? Finish those off. What were you? All I saw was a whiffed, whiff, a whiffed, no, a whiff of smoke. Oh, I don't have an axe. I do have an axe right there. Yeah, it's been a long. Oh, yeah, I gotta turn that off. Oh yeah, I probably should do this too. Long couple of days here. We had a birthday party yesterday, only it was an actual party, not just the standard family get together that we have. There's so many people. And on top of that, I put together a basketball hoop, which let me tell you, is not easy to do. Wow, I was not expecting it to be as difficult as it turned out to be. It was. Oh, all right. Well, I need some more steps, it looks like. It said you needed two people to do it, but I swear we needed four in the end to finally get it all put together. It was pretty crazy. You have to put the rim on for this particular model while you're putting on the backboard. Oh, I did have some steps on me. I'm probably gonna need some more slabs. There we go. That's the word as well. But yeah, we finally got it all put together and shot a little bit of basketball last night, which really, really made my wrist hurt. It's been way too long since I have shot a basketball. Well, I wouldn't say too long. I would just say it's been a long time. Let's say that. If I never shot a basketball again, it probably wouldn't make that big a difference to me. But yeah, so heck, they even let off some fireworks last night. Just crazy. One of the guys who came over, his boss had some leftover fireworks and, yep, can't do that. And knew that he was really into fireworks, so he gave him fireworks. I know I've talked about fireworks on here before, and they're all right for what they are, but I play a lot of video games, or I try to play a lot of video games, and yeah. Got all my fireworks in my video games, thanks. Oh, and then I was just getting the mail. I freaking got jury summons. I've never actually attended. I usually am in class, and so I've gotten out of it every time before this. I don't want to go to jury duty. Why should I go to jury duty? Seems like a terrible day to me. can you just go there, please? Not only that, but it's not just jury duty, it's a 3 month window of jury duty. I don't even know how it works. Like I said, I've never gone. I can't imagine it should be too terrible. Although, looking at the clothing requirements, I'm probably gonna have to buy some new clothes to go to jury duty. I don't really have much in the way of business casual attire. I assume you can get away with that. I don't want to wear a shirt and tie. I know they like to pretend that it's all some kind of major thing, but yeah, this isn't the 1800s. The one for me is, why can't I wear a t-shirt? I can understand saying I have to wear a plain t-shirt, but really? What's the difference if my shirt has a collar on it or not? You must wear clothing appropriate to the situation. That's what it says. I got a little. It came with a pamphlet about jury duty. And that's what it says in there. No t-shirt, jeans, tank tops, shorts. It's July, all right? I don't. Who knows if they even have an air conditioner in there? It's gonna be terrible. Just thinking about it. Ugh. It's terrible. Jury duty. This is. It also. You'd think that with all the people who live in the area, and I know I say I live in the middle of nowhere, but there are thousands and thousands of people that live within the county I live in. Maybe even tens of thousands, I don't know. I'll bet there's probably at least 50,000 people or more that live, which I know sounds very tiny. How am I supposed to get those over there? Now I want to know. I'm gonna Google it. Hold on. Let's see. Oh yeah, see, I was right. 54,000 people. So you're telling me that of the 54,000 people who live here, and the ones who are age appropriate, that's my course dirt, isn't it? The ones who are age appropriate, this will be like the third or fourth time that I have received a jury summons. You're telling me that you have gone through the gamut of all the people who are available, and that it's now down to me to come be a juror. Really? I don't think so. Gonna go this time, I think, though. Maybe they'll stop having me back. I don't know how many trials in our area go to jury, and seems to me my sister had jury duty and she didn't even have to go to court. She just had to wait for a trial that would go to a jury, and everything else was just summoned through or summoned, completed through. Courtroom deals, I guess. 'Cause we're really in the middle of nowhere. I don't know. It's extremely irritating to me. It's one of those things where it's like, well, it's your civic duty. No. Pretty sure my civic duty is to pay my taxes. I don't understand why jury duty isn't on more of a volunteer basis. There are people I know my age who have lived in the same area as me their entire lives who have never been summoned for jury duty. Ever. And they want to be summoned for jury duty. So this is literally my at least third, possibly fourth time. I can't quite remember the exact numbers, but I do know that at least once or twice while I was a student, and this is at least the second or third time. You know what? I'm gonna say five times. I'm gonna say I've received a jury summons five times now. At least twice while I was a student, and at least this will be the third time as a instructor. I know this will be my third time as an instructor. So at least four times, maybe five. And there are people I know who have never been summoned. It's ridiculous. It's a punishment. It's a punishment for not getting tickets. I'm sure that's exactly what it is. I've never gotten a traffic ticket of any kind. I've never been stopped by the police. Like, an accident report is the closest I've ever gotten to the police. So this is like a punishment for, not screwing up. Hate it. I hate it. As if there wasn't enough stuff that I am being required to do this summer that I don't want to do. Now we get to throw this on top of it. I tell ya. Let's hope I left my. I did. I couldn't remember if I brought my cart or left my cart in here or not. I gotta go get some clay to work on this thing. So we're gonna take a ride on the reading. No, this isn't the reading. It says you can't even take mobile devices. Mobile devices are not allowed in the courthouse, it says. No cell phones, no tablets, no laptops. Happens if you fall asleep during the trial. Because I will be so bored. Maybe it'll be some kind of crazy murder trial, and then at least I'll be interested in, right? Maybe I won't get summoned. I'll go and they'll disqualify me from the jury pool. That'd be nice. I'll just have to prove that I don't have an open mind. That was on the list too. The only things. Let me look at this. This was funny to me. You do not need any special skills or legal knowledge to be a juror. All you need is an open mind and readiness to work with other jurors to make decisions. You think if I told him I hate people, that would work because I hate people. And this just enforces my hatred of people. Aw, really? Man, how many more of those things do I need? One, Two. Oh, seriously? I missed it by two. Where did I leave that cart? Yeah, but that's something I'm not looking forward to. For sure. I mean, I'm gonna be in the middle of remodeling the house. Well, parts of the house. I'd planned on getting some certification for work this summer. Oh yeah, I kind of wanted to ride in that. I do think you're only re like you go and then they put you on a short time frame. And then that's it. And then if there isn't a jury trial during the time period, you are a juror. I think that's how it worked for my sister. She's the last person in our house who has been summoned. Of course, in her job, she winds up at the courthouse all the time. But, it's crazy. All right. Now, I am gonna want some. What color is this? Light stain, light gray. I think I'd like something darker than that. I mean, if I could just get standard clay, which is there's a ton of it here, then I can dye it once I get back. Which is probably what I'm gonna wind up doing. What color is this? Is this orange or red? That's red. Okay. It's been so long since I worked with the clays that I don't remember the colors. I know some of these have got yellows. I might go with the yellow. Is this clay or is this sand again? This is clay. This is the orange, right? I think I'm gonna do the orange. I'm gonna use the orange as the color for my cab. And then I'll probably just take some, oops. Some normal hardened clay. And then dye that. I'm probably gonna want a couple of stacks of orange. I don't know that I'll use a couple of stacks, but ooh. Watch out for that pit there, buddy. But it's better to have it than not have it, right? Oh, don't go down the pit. I need you. And then we got last week of work this week for the summer. Excited for that. Oh man. Just thinking about all the stuff I've got to do this summer. Summer's not going to be long enough to finish it all. And then jury duty on top of that. Yeah, I know the first time I got jury summons, I was that looks like, is that just dirt? That's just dirt, because if it was coarse dirt, it would pop into my inventory. The first time I got it, I was this full-time student. And I'm not sure if I ever got it again while I was a student. But I know the last time, or the first time I got it as an instructor, one of my own students was a clerk who was on the juror selection staff, and so I thought that was a little hinky. But Yeah. Don't people just leave you alone? I don't want to do stuff. Pay my taxes, I vote once in a while. Not enough. I'm not anybody's peer. Think I sound like the small town small town peer. I've talked about how nobody I know plays video games, nobody I know watches the shows I watch, nobody I know reads. How does that make me anybody's peer? Anyways, I'm gonna stop complaining about it now. I'm just gonna be irritated by it. All right, we almost got enough stuff here, and then we'll head back. And that's it right there. Oh, look, there's the yellow. I really could use some cyan or black stained. I want black stained, I'm pretty sure, for the part I'm about to do. And I was kind of hoping to find that, but I didn't see any anywhere. Of course, I was also hoping to have enough powered rail to finish off that rail. I didn't have that either. I also haven't put in the push button on this end, right? Oh no, I did. Can't remember if I put that there or not. I could move that forward to. Two spots. Come on, get moving. There we go. But yeah, it's after you get home from work at the end of the week, and then so we got my nephew a basketball hoop. That we had to set up. And it's just been sitting there in its box, up against the wall so you couldn't see what it is in the garage. And I had talked about when we were going to put it together. And and so they didn't want to put it together too early so we'd see it, so they wanted it done right before the party, which is about when I get home from work. And so I get home and nobody's even looked at it. And so changed out of my work clothes and drug it out and opened it up to see what was gonna need to happen to put it together. No instructions. There were no instructions in the box, so I had to run in, grab my tablet, look it up online, and then I start putting it together, and nobody has come out to even look. And so I come inside, I'm like, I need some help on this thing. I can't hold all this in place and put the nuts and bolts together. It takes too many hands. I've got two. I need about six. And so finally, my sister came out, and she held up while I worked on one part. And then when I got that part done, obviously her husband had to wander off to do something else, and so the kids started being, kids and started screaming and crying. So she had to quit helping and go inside to take care of her kids. And so that left me outside again, working on it all by myself. And then I get to the point where almost where well no, the other two guys live here, the husband and the other guy lives here. They both wandered by while I was working. And when I came inside the first time to get help, the one guy had actually gone to a completely different floor of the house than where he was at before, because he'd seen that I was working on this and did not want to help. And so obviously, it's better to go hide than to offer to help. And it's not like it was heavy or anything. It was just awkward because it's not meant to be on an angle on the edge while you try to feed bolts through the backboard and the pole and the stand and the hoop. So then got all the way down to needing to put the backboard on, and nobody's there again. And so I went inside and I'm like, I really can't do this by myself still. And so they the my brother-in-law, he comes out and he's like, "Well, I was just gonna wait till other people from the party got here and then make them put together." I'm like, "Really? We bought the gift and you want someone else to put it together for you?" "Well, they like to put stuff together." So yeah, he was not happy. He was very, very perturbed that we decided to put the gift we bought together instead of him trying to make someone else do it for him. And yeah, it was crazy difficult to get the last couple parts on. It you had to put the Well, following the directions, since I've never put together a basketball hoop like that before, our old basketball hoop where I grew up was bolted to the side of the barn, right? The hoop was just directly bolted onto a piece of plywood onto the side of the barn. Like, the plywood was Where are there are 12 of them. A piece of plywood was nailed to the barn, and then bolts went through the hoop into the barn wall, and that's it. So this was a bit of a new experience for me, and the way it was set up was first you put the pole together, and then you put the pole in the stand, and then once you've got the pole mounted onto the stand, which required several steps, then I had to put the backboard and the rim on at the same time. The bolts that hold the backboard on hold the rim on. And there's this little tiny metal piece that is not connected to anything that has to go between the backboard and the pole. And so you have to hold that in place while you're holding the backboard and the rim, and trying to get the screws through it while you have the pole held down on an angle low enough so that you can reach it. So I'm not sure how they expected two people to be able to do all that. We wound up with three or four at one point, and we finally got it all put together. It was pretty crazy. Okay, so I've got that, and now I'm gonna take the black and the hardened clay. All right. Oh, you know what? That was black clay. I was thinking that was brown clay. Oh, and I should probably sleep. I think I prefer it to be daytime while I'm out here working. Sploop. Sliding off the bed. Wow. Did you guys see all these guys out there when we left earlier? 'Cause I didn't. All right, so this is going to be the base that it's mounted on. Which I'm probably going to need. I'm going to need more clay than I was thinking I was going to need. All right. Maybe. Maybe not. Okay. Well, I'm gonna need more than I currently have because I've got to run another at least one or two more rows up. It's a good thing I got two stacks. Yep, that's orange clay, buddy. Oop, wrong way. And then today would have been a good day to sleep, but I did not do it. I don't know why. I thought, man, this would be a great day to sleep in because everybody left this morning at about 11. I woke up at 9:30, which is about a half hour after I wake up during the week for work. That's not true. I wish I woke up at 9 for work. 9 is when I set my alarm. 9 is the absolute last moment I could stay in bed and still get to work on time. I think I want to go one higher. Yes. Will you stop placing torches? Oh, I can't make it. Nope, that's not gonna work either. Okay, and then we'll take the orange. I might not have brought enough orange. And stop placing torches. Then we'll do this. Man, this thing is gonna be huge. It's supposed to be, though. Okay, and I'm sure some of this I'll have to fill in. All right, so the cockpit then would be here. Okay. Well, I don't think it'd be here necessarily. Let's move it over here. I got a plan for this thing. So what I'm gonna do is there'll be a little spot to drive it here, which probably will have more of an opening on the sides here. No, that's terrible. There we go. And then there'll be another one here, but it'll be up another couple blocks, and that will have the crane part, and there'll be a cockpit for the crane as well. And it definitely needs a ladder to get up and down, which I'm gonna have to put on yet. Which will probably be stairs stacked, instead of actual ladders, but yeah, I think that's coming along pretty good. So, all right, with that, click like if you like, subscribe if you're sure and catch the next one. I might lower that down one actually. I think that's up too high. But yeah, I'll talk to you later.
Thank you.